This is Roger Struckoff with Syscon TV. We're sitting here with Ermanno Bonifazi with Solgenia. He has come from Italy. The company's based in Canada. And that's kind of a metaphor almost for cloud computing and the global nature of it. Ermanno would like to talk to us today about cloud consumption. What do you have to say about that?
Interesting. Cloud consumption is something that we envision at Solgenia that is trying to really let the cloud spread to the user as a consumption, so as a utility computing. Because if we look around what is really today on the cloud, most is about subscription services that is not really utility computing. So what we envision at Solgenia is to allow the people to use really what they want to use and get the service that they need, but on a real consumption model. That's what we do, that's what we envision, that's what we build. So to allow the people really to pay for what they use, not just a subscription model.
You know, this is the thing, because people have talked about this utility model. It's like water or electricity. It's much more complex than that. However, today, even most people doing this, it's still, I would call, high granularity. You can buy it on consumption, yet you're buying big chunks. You can't really measure it, and you're trying to take that the next level?
To the next level. That's exactly what we did. We patent and we build a platform that is named Power, Solgenia Power, and this platform is exactly focusing on taking the IT to the utility. So it's exactly, I love to say that, as you said, if the, you know, cloud is like the electricity, the idea is exactly we are the counter. So we are the one that transform everything that is a consumption model. So we allow you to have your application on a pure consumption model as exactly pay the infrastructure, exactly for the infrastructure that you use. So you can pay the amount of CPU time, you can pay the amount of disk, you can even pay the amount of transaction that you made in that application. And you have your bill at the end of the month. So it is exactly like the telecommunication. It's no more that you pay a subscription, but at the end, right, you are not sure if this month you are using really that amount of software or computing power. So.
And then how instantaneous is it? I mean, people try to capacity plan, but maybe as they get to this era, they can be a little more flexible. And suddenly, what sort of spikes do you see? Or maybe before that, I should ask, what sort of customer do you have in mind? What sort of customer do you have? And what sort of variation do you see with them?
Yeah, actually, we have more than 3,500 customers already on this platform. So, and we see that we divide the market in three big chunks, of which one is telecommunication company. Because, you know, telecommunication company are now transforming themselves into be more a cloud provider. So they need some kind of platform to get out from, you know, selling just minutes of traffic and sell more application infrastructure solution. So we enable them to do that. At the same time, we use this platform for large enterprise customers that they want to measure their consumption of their infrastructure and be able to charge back to the right department. The third market, the third piece of the market we are approaching is the government, because also government is consolidating their data centers, so they need to save money. But at the end, when you consolidate something, you want also to be able to have the same granularity of information about who is using what, and so you should charge back that infrastructure consumption.
How does this work in sort of the hybrid environment? Do you have clients that are still doing on-site? And if so, how are they using your service?
Yeah, exactly. Platform itself, Power, allow you to build public, private, or hybrid cloud solution. So we are very hard pushing hybrid cloud, because I believe that hybrid cloud is one of the best technology. It's something that we have did into our platform, is allow the people to have their application on the cloud, their infrastructure on the cloud, but at the same time still keep their data on their own premises. So this gives them the confidence of having, you know, more ownership on the data, more security on the privacy of the data, while getting rid of the cost of maintaining application and infrastructure.
So that's, to me, that's a very enlightened approach, because a few years ago people was sort of either or, but in fact you're not only not fighting hybrid, you embrace it, you encourage it.
Totally. I believe that there is also a specific space for each single model. Public cloud, I believe, will be very strong in, you know, SMB space. That's my personal vision. I believe SMB may benefit a lot from public cloud solution, because they do not have, you know, the resources, and they don't need to have the resources for using application or infrastructure. So public cloud would work very well for them. private cloud, big corporation, they want, you know, to control everything. So that's clearly where we want to be. But at the same time, I believe that hybrid cloud will be very, very important all around the market and the globe, because this is really something that can fulfill the needs for SMB and at the same time even enterprise customer that want to, you know, reduce their spending for just managing, as I said before, infrastructure or application, but at the same time keep more security on their data. People that is sensible with their data. I mean, you know that even different country have different law about, you know, how to manage data. So probably in this sense, hybrid cloud is something that really we push a lot because we believe it's the right way also to monetize the cloud.
Yeah, this is a very sophisticated conversation for me. This is wonderful because it's pay as you go, but it's neither black nor white. A small business, yes, might have a tendency with a lack of capital expenditure or inability for capital expenditure. Larger companies want the control, have the CapEx, yet it's not that clear. Across the board, the different customers are using different things. They're offering, they're really taking things to the next generation. 3,500 customers, so this is not something that's new to them. So we've been joined for a few minutes by Ermanno Bonifazi. I can say it. It's not that hard. From Solgenia, thank you very much for being
thank
our
you,
guest.
Yeah.
Solgenia, go check him out. This is Roger Strukoff for Syscon TV.